This conference will now be recorded.
Hi everyone. This is a video which I'm creating for especially for your children. So I have given some updates earlier also. So for new people who are seeing this video, it will be an eye opener. So this is a scheme where I'm telling you like how you can make investments in mutual fund account for your children, and then you can grow into a multifold and crorepati. So this is a sample file which I created and started implementing for my son. When he attained 18 years of age, I opened a mutual fund account for his name, and what are the pocket money I'm giving to him, and just putting in the investments in this on monthly basis. So the investment starts with 5000 rupees per month, and then you should not put any lump sum amount, and you have to keep on investing on this, and we'll have some rules and regulations also. I will just show you also. We have to every year increase the investment by 15% here. Okay, maybe you can reduce to 5-10%, 5%, whatever is possible. Okay, but it should be in the son's name, girl's name, child's name, in the name account, not in your name. That's very important. And the target is by age of 50 years. Once he starts investing, he or she must start investing from 18th year, then the investment will continue till 50th year. But no incremental investment is required. Only till 40th year, you have to keep on increasing the investment by 15% every year. But after the last 10 years, no need for any incremental investment. You can continue to put investment as 1 lakh rupees. Now, as of now, it looks very big amount for you. But after, say, 30 years, this amount could be very less for you. Because after 30 years, 1 lakh rupees may not have much value actually. The 10,000 rupees, what we have value now, with the before 20 years, 30 years, there are big value. So this will happen. Here you have to invest in the mutual funds. The allocation of the different funds I'll tell you, explain you. And here till 50th year you have to invest the total investment, whatever corpus comes to 18 crores by end of 50th year, you invest in the FD account, and then that FD return you put in FD account. This total amount 18 crores, you will get a monthly FD interest of almost like 6.7 lakhs after tax. So this is a complete plan all about. And assuming a 15% growth rate on the investments in the mutual fund over a long period of time. If you see like any mutual fund account, if you just select all the funds actually overall, if you see any plan, if you see at least 15%, you can give majority of funds will give you 15% return. You can see in the last 5 years, you can see 15% return is possible. Okay. And that too, if you have some exit and in booking profits, then you can achieve better returns also. So this is a mutual fund account which I just opened in the Kite Zurada. Okay, these are the funds actually. I have put some redemption and then added some investments. And this, what are the schemes I have invested? I just showed you here. Total 84,000 is there, whatever is there. And that amount I just kept bifurcated also separately. I'll show that separately. Here, if the investment, the monthly, yearly incremental savings, whatever you're doing, if I reduce it to say 10%, you can see the goal will come to 11 crores. If you increase by 15%, then goal 18 crores. If you can increase to 20%, then your goal increases 30 crores. So this is how the change happens actually with the incremental savings year on year. So what are the rules and regulations we have to follow here? So monthly SIP, though no lump sum, that is very important. The rules you have to follow like this. The total portfolio should not go below the planned investment at any given point of time. Here, if you see here, the total investment planned is almost like 81,000, and the mutual fund current portfolio, what you can see is 85,000. You can shift between any funds, no problem, but you should never redeem that amount and make it cash and use that amount in case emergency or something like that also. You have to keep that amount as it is in the mutual fund portfolio, dedicated for children, and you should not touch the fund at all at any cost. That kind of amount only you can invest. If you feel that 5,000 is high, you can start with 1,000 rupees also. Something like that you can start. Assume that you are increasing, you are making to start with 1,000. Then at least 1,000 rupees, if you keep investing, then the target is almost like 3.6 crores. And assume that your investment is almost like now, I'm doing 10,000. If you can make it 10,000 rupees, if you can make it 10,000 rupees, then 36 crores is possible. So this is how the change happens actually. With a small increase in the savings, then that goes to a big amount. The mistakes what we do is whenever there is emergency, you try to take it the amount for emergency use, then that amount, this goal cannot be achieved. So that if you feel that emergency, you have to touch this fund, then start with a small amount, but you have to very strictly ensure that don't touch this amount at any cost. Next rule is that this applicable for both boy and boy and girl child. If you have a girl child, then you should open the account in the girl's name, and then that amount also hand over to her after the marriage, and then they should continue that till the 50th year, and their family also get benefited. Okay, don't think that is only for boys and they only should take her like that. It's for both boys and girls. So the total mutual funds what you have should not exceed 10 actually. So what I've done is I've made some allocation of funds actually to own sectoral funds. FMCG, pharma, banking, IT, these are four sector funds which is predominantly gives good returns seasonally sometimes, but banking will be all-time seasonal actually, all-time favorite, and there is no seasonal. Like pharma was down for some time, almost 3-4 years, then suddenly started giving good returns. IT also has given good returns. So actually I invested now, I don't have any holding in pharma or IT as of now because it has gone up so much. I booked some profit and I closed the positions here. I have an FMCG little, around 6% of my portfolio, and in the banking around 17% of portfolio is what the investment I have. And here the total sectoral funds allocation, I'm telling that should be like 35% minimum should be there. It's up to you, like how much you want to keep it. I have some allocation portfolio which I plan. Maybe I'll fine tune this over a period of time. And the small cap, large cap, mid cap, all these funds, the combination, flexi cap, whatever you can tell, this total 20 to 30% allocation is maybe ideal. So currently, as of now, if you see here, I have made investment of almost like 30% in this. 30% in this. These are the funds which I have allocated actually. And maybe I'll over a period of time, I'll try to minimize this and make it into 3 or 4 only. And then Nifty ETF also is there. I have four types of Nifty funds. One is Nifty Equal 50 fund, on the next year, next 50 fund, and then Prudential Nifty Low. This is low volatility. This is the NFO fund which is launched actually. And then Nifty Motri Crossfall, Nifty 500 fund. So these are Nifty ETF funds actually, which I have allocated, which is coming down 23% actually. This also I will try to reduce to some extent, and so that my total funds not exceed 10. Maybe 10 we can increase to maximum is 15. 15 should be also maybe like very high, I feel 12. 10 to 12 should be, I think, ideal. I think we should not have more than that. Then gold ETF is one fund, DSP World Gold Fund, 10% of allocation I have made. And then Parag Parikh Flexi Cap Fund. This Flexi Cap Fund has allocation to the international stocks also, like Amazon, Apple, Google, and so on. So Facebook also is there. I think so. These stocks we should have focus on. This includes large cap funds also, and also some international funds also, stocks also. And then debt fund. Debt fund currently has 6% allocation. I will increase it to 10%, 15% like that in the coming days. And then I want, because as the market is getting heated up and overvaluation has seen, if there is any downtrend started seeing again, then I may shift some, close some, book some profit in these funds, and then profit loss, whatever, I book some profit here and then move to debt funds. The total allocation of my portfolio I've shown here how it is coming. And also you can see some, because I keep some profit booking also done earlier days. So I'll just show you like what is the profit I have booked. I mentioned here like total profit I have booked is 17,000 here. As of now, realized unrealized profit, whatever is there here, is around 8K should be the unrealized return. Okay, that makes total investment plus return of 18K. I have made some booked a profit, some 17K. That's the reason my investment, if you see here, in the portfolio here, you can see like there is no like flat, there's no return. Even if you see like after Bank Nifty falling by 20%, my portfolio is down by only 4% here actually. So I'll be adding some, even Monday also I'll add some 1,000 rupees like that, so that you can see the portfolio will be slowly increasing and getting averaged down. And here, let me just show to the P&L also here in the mutual funds. And let me just take you from the last year, 1st March till now. Till now, you can see like a total 17.6K. This is a total profit booked actually. Maybe like some small loss also is 160 rupees, something small loss is there. Maybe that is not required actually. But just at the beginning, I made some booking of profits like pharma fund. You know, possible that I was expecting some profit was maybe like there will be reversal. That's the reason I closed. But over a period of time, you learn actually a lot. Okay, so this is the way how you can see the mutual funds, how it's getting return. Whenever you select a mutual fund, you go to the options and select which sectors, and then you can go for the right mid cap funds, what are mid cap, small cap, large cap, whatever funds you want to select, you can select. And also see the what is asset under management. Asset under management is very important. Very high asset under management is better actually. And also return over 5 years. And any new fund starting in the 1 year old or 2 years old, it's better to go for funds which is more than 5 years, which is showing the performance So one tax plan is which is showing, but the asset under management is only 106 crores. So here the what happens that whenever there is a requirement here tax plan, there is a lock-in period, so there is no issues. But certain other funds there is a very low asset under management is there. If you just sort it out and see 10 crores, 15 crores, 25 crores, what happens that there will be very lot of shuffling will be there and redemption pressure comes. Then it'll be difficult for them to manage and make returns, good returns actually. So don't go for any asset, any mutual fund portfolio where the asset under management is very less. Go for something asset under management which is more than 10,000 crores, 5,000, 10,000 crores at least should be there. So this is the total portfolio which I want to show you, and you also start doing this for your children once they start 18 years. If they, if you have, maybe like if you can open an account, separate account in your name when the child is young or born, newly born, and open the account and think that it is your child's mutual fund portfolio. And then once they become 18 years, then shift the entire portfolio to their in their own name and open the investments also in their own name and put all the money there only. So that this is going to be a big wealth building game for the children actually. Once they attain 50 years of age, like getting some 6 lakhs and after tax return monthly is something, a big gift that you can give for your children. I'm sure this is going to be a helpful thing for you, and please implement this. It's not going to cost you anything. It's just one initiative you have to do in your, if you think that you want to do something good for your children, and this is the one thing you can do, financial good thing. I mean, not only you're teaching them good habits, attitudes, and so many other things and education, but this is also very important. Financial literacy is a very, very important thing. The literacy is also important, but more than that, financial literacy is very, very important. Please try to educate them and tell them what is important in their life and how to accumulate wealth. See, now if you see the investment is almost like 5,000, 10,000 rupees or 1 lakh rupees. Once after some time, like for example, when they attain after 10 years, when somebody starts 18 years, and now once the portfolio go to around 20, 30 years, when they reach 30 years, their portfolio can come to around 45 lakhs. Okay, the 45 lakhs means what happens that they need to manage it. After certain time, like once they're, for example, 35 years, when they go to 35 years of age, then the portfolio comes to 1 crore. So that time you need to know how to hedge your portfolio, how you can manage your portfolio. Like every day, if you see, like for example, a 1% movement in the market, if you can see 1 lakh, 2 lakh rupees movement, you can see. So that is very easy and going to be very difficult to manage unless otherwise they manage emotionally and have logical thinking of how to manage the funds. After a certain time, like 40 years, 50 years, you can see the portfolio easily going to around 10, 11, 12, 15 crores. So this thing, like every day, every month, you are going to invest 1 lakh rupees, and here the portfolio hedging and all, that's going to be very important. So let them, if they are going to be engineering students or medical, whatever, they need, unless they have the financial knowledge, they cannot manage the funds. So there are two types of problems while coming to money. One is too much money, too less money. When you have this much of portfolio and the person who is working, and when they see a portfolio moving down by like almost like, for example, when you have portfolio 15 crores, then easily like 10, 15 lakhs movement, you can see the movement. And that time you may shift it to debt funds. Okay, you need to know how to shift your funds to debt funds, equity funds. That's very important. For example, market crashing, like assume that you have the portfolio 16 crores. And this portfolio ballooning to 16 crores and the March 2020 crash comes. That time this 16 crores easily will go to 8 crores, correct? 50% it was coming down easily. Unless you book profit on regular time travels, the problem is very difficult to digest this kind of drawdowns in the portfolio. So unless you have that systematic way of booking profits, and whenever you can see some good returns, valuation is very high, shifted debt funds or some safety funds, balance fund, these kind of things you have to educate your children also. It's not that you keep on investing here and suddenly some big drawdown comes, some big depression comes, or a market goes down significantly. You need to manage it. The children should know how to manage also. This kind of education also is very important so that this amount of growth, whatever you are expecting here, can be achieved. So hope you understand what I'm trying to tell. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe and like the channel so that I can give some regular updates on this and so many other things in the days to come. Thank you.